Now, you may or may not know, keep the nose down, will you, fellas? I've got to do a link. You may or may not know, me and Buster here have changed lodgings. Bang, bang, bang. So you can now watch the Paul O'Grady... Am I supposed to concentrate with all this racket going on? The Paul O'Grady Show. Do it again. The Paul O'Grady Show. All singing, all dancing, dogs, fabulous celebrities, competitions, and we've got my beautiful organ. Go easy with that organ. The Paul O'Grady Show, live on Channel 4 at 5 o'clock. Call them builders. They've got two speeds, slow and coma. Give us a ring when you're finished, will you? I'll be in a canteen.
The new Paul O'Grady Show starts Monday at 5 on 4.
It may be late at night, but the only four-letter words in Countdown will be on the board in very low-scoring games.
I'm ready for the next contestant now.
Now, have you missed us? Do you think they've missed us, Carol? We've been away since Monday, haven't we? Because of the Cheltenham Festival.
Absolutely, but Cheltenham was marvellous.
It was good. I went down there yesterday.
Yeah?
Nothing. Well, plenty to drink, but nothing nothing as far as the betting is concerned. Because it's Saturday, I've got a few of those little football...
Oh, well, of course, yes. We have to allow you this, don't we?
Yeah. Quote from Kevin Keegan, former England manager. England have the best fans in the world, and Scotland's fans are second to none. Harry Redknapp. I like the Harry Redknapp.
They're the best.
Harry. With the foreign players, it's more difficult. Most of them don't even bother with a golf. They don't want to go racing. They don't even drink.
Is that just me?
No, it's scrub Harry Redknapp jokes. How about this one from...
God, blimey.
How about this one from Glenn Hoddle? International football is one clog further up the football ladder. Dave Bassett. It'd be foolish to believe that automatic promotion is automatic in any way whatsoever.
I like that.
The last one from Ron Atkinson. If Glenn Hoddle said one word to his team at halftime, it was concentration and focus.
Very good.
How about that?
Very good. Very good, Des. Well, today is a very special day. I don't know if anyone's been counting, but I have, because I am the queen of numbers on Countdown.
You are.
Today, Desmond Lynam is your 100th Countdown.
It is. That's cool. I think it is.
Yeah? 100 shows. I know it might seem like a lot longer, but I've got a little present for
you.
Have
you really? This
100 is, this shows. Now, this is a very special present.
Right.
And I'm glad it's being given to you on a Saturday.
Why?
Because, well, you'll see. Just open it.
No, just
100
open.
Shows.
How does it open? Does that come off?
Yeah, like that.
Oh, heavens above. What about this?
Okay, open it up. What is this?
It's an England shirt.
England shirt with...
The name on the back.
Lynam 100.
How about that? Fantastic. Thank you, darling. If I could have played for England, what a dream that would have been.
Wouldn't that be fantastic?
If I could have played for anybody, what a dream.
And we haven't just gone to any old market stall and shoved a few numbers out. This has been specially commissioned by the FA.
Has it really?
Yeah.
Fantastic. What a joy. Yeah. Thank you very much indeed. That's very, very kind. I get three kisses as well.
It's a happy one.
Are we doing anything for my 101st?
That's between you and I, darling.
Thank you very much indeed. Lovely. That's very kind of you. Thank you very much indeed. Very nice. Very nice. I feel I've gone red a little. Anyway, blood pressure. Right, let's meet our contestants. It's difficult today because we've got two Ians. We've got Ian Graham, who's our champion over there. He's won 5 in a row. His top score last time with 108. It's quite brilliant. He's the former classics master from Dumbarton. That's Ian on the far side. And we have another Ian, a challenger, Ian Alexander, Lives in Dis in Norfolk. Single man, yes?
Yep.
He's an office administrator these days, but your hobby is music, and you perform a bit, don't you?
I do, yeah. It's just me and by myself, singing, a bit of plucking and a bit of twanging.
Yeah, well, do you perform by yourself?
I occasionally have guest stars.
Do you?
Well, you know, in my gigs.
Good. Oh, excellent. Good. Well, you'll get a few more gigs by appearing on this show. I'm going to call our champion the champ, so that we can differentiate between the two. He's the champ, and this is Ian. Give him a nice, warm welcome, ladies and gentlemen.
And just a couple more introductions to make. Well, Des, 100 shows today.
Yes.
Well, the man with Susie Dent in Dictionary Corner has appeared on Countdown just a few more times than that, almost 150 times, in fact. So much so that he knows this show backwards. We know him backwards as Frank Phillips, or more familiarly, forwards as Philip Franks.
It has, however, taken me 15 years to notch up 150 shows. When I get to my 200th, will you get a doublet and hose with a ruff embroidered Frank's 200 on the back?
Is that what you'd like?
It's a bit Shakespearean.
Oh, marvellous. We should do that for you, definitely.
Thank you.
Be warned.
Uh-oh.
You don't want the football shirt then, Philip?
Be careful what you wish for. No, Des, that's yours. That's yours.
That's
wear it with pride.
I shall do in due course. I hope it fits. Right, let's get on with it. And we'll start with, as I say, our champ, with your letters.
Consonant, please, Carol.
Thank you. D.
And another one.
R.
And a third.
Y.
A vowel.
I.
And another one.
O.
And another one.
E.
Consonant.
M.
Another consonant.
R.
And another vowel.
And I.
And your time starts now. You want to start, I think. Ian, how did you go?
I only got five.
Just days. Five, yeah, I quite understand that. Champ?
Five also.
Just five. Go on, sir.
Dryer.
Dryer and?
Rider.
Rider. Dryer and rider. Two fives there, Susie.
Yep, both fine.
What about Philip?
Well, we have a six over here in the corner. It's dormer, that's as in window rather than Nessun.
Yeah, ER at the end.
Excellent. Right. Ian, let's have a go with your letters.
Consonant, please.
N.
And another.
L.
And another.
D.
A vowel.
O.
A vowel.
A.
Consonant.
T.
Vowel.
I.
Another vowel.
O.
And a consonant, please.
And C.
And we'll start the clock. We'll come to our champion first.
Eight.
Eight. Ian?
Six.
Six. Go on, Ian.
Action.
Action. And an eight.
Location.
Well
location.
Done.
Location.
Very good.
You were kicking yourself there, weren't you?
Yeah.
Nearly saw it in time. Philip?
Can't do any better than that. Location, no. Location, location.
Absolutely. We love it. Right, the score's 13 and 5, and our champ now to choose his letters.
Consonant, please, Carol.
Thank you, champ. G.
And another one.
Q.
And another one.
P.
Vowel.
A.
Vowel.
E.
Vowel.
A.
Consonant.
S.
Consonant.
G.
And another consonant,
and
please.
And a consonant, thank you. And D.
Here we go, gentlemen.
Thank you.
tricky-looking selection, I would have thought. Ian?
Six.
Champ?
Six.
Go on, then.
Adages.
Adages and?
Sagged.
Sagged. Adages and sagged.
Adages and sagged.
That's all we have over here.
Mm? Yeah. It was our loss, I'm afraid. Couldn't get
beyond
six.
That's your lot. Just sixes all round, eh?
Just six.
If you did better at home, if you got a seven or an eight, very well done. We couldn't compete with you. Now, let's look at the score. It's 19 and 11. Our champion leads by those 8 points at the moment. But Ian, we'll now have your letters.
A vowel, please.
Thank you, Ian. I.
And another.
E.
And a consonant.
S.
Another consonant.
N.
Another consonant.
H.
A vowel, please.
A.
A consonant.
Z.
A consonant.
D.
And a consonant.
And R.
30 seconds starts right now. Champ.
Seven.
This Ian?
Seven.
Go on.
Handier.
Handier. Champion?
Hard. Hardens.
Hardens.
Yep.
Yeah, both good.
Both fine for seven, yep.
Yeah. You could have had sandier as well, or sardine.
Yes.
Oh. But you couldn't have had Xanders with an S. Xander is also a fish, yes. But its plural is the same as its singular.
It is, yep.
So oh, it's
Xander.
At home.
It's cropped up a few times lately, hasn't it?
Has,
it
has, yes. Yeah. Richard Dyson's lost fishing for them.
It's a river fish, isn't it, I think?
It is a river fish, a bit like the perch, I think.
Perch or pike.
Yeah.
Good, 7 points apiece there. It's 26 and 18 at the moment. Right, it's numbers time, and our champion will now make his selection with Carol.
One from the top.
One from the top.
Five from the third.
Thank you very much, Ian. Your classic, personal classic selection. OK, we have six and four. 4 and 9, 3 and 25. And a target, ooh, wow, 827.
827. Ian?
827.
827, well done, champ.
827.
Ian, you do it. You have a go.
OK, 9 fours are 36.
Yeah, 9 multiplied by 4, 36.
Minus 3.
Is 33.
Multiplied by 25.
Is 825.
And then you've got 6 minus 4 to get the 2.
Yeah. And add that on. 827.
Very good, excellent. 10 points. Now the other Ian, our champion.
100 minus 3, 25 multiplied by 4.
Gives you the 100, yes. And then?
Then minus 8.
Now, how did you make that 8?
Which is 6 divided by 3.
Times 4.
Multiplied by the other 4.
Is 8.
Subtract.
Subtract is 92.
Multiplied by the other, by 9, and it's wrong, sorry.
Yeah, that's wrong, I'm afraid.
Bad luck, very bad luck.
Yeah.
It's 72, that's 828, that would give you, I'm
so
afraid.
We have a very interesting scoreline now. Our challenger, Ian Alexander, leads by 2 points against our 5 times champion. So that's the situation here. Now we'll hear from Mr. Philip Franks. Philip.
A nail biter, so lighten the mood a bit here. Now, you'll all remember there's a game called Chinese Roulette, which is neither Oriental nor does it involve spinning a wheel. It's the game where you go, if this person were a blank, what blank would they be? Be it a car, a colour, a children's TV show, that kind of thing. That's when you find out that your friends think of you either as bagpuss or a clapped-out old Skoda with 3 wheels. It can be rather hurtful. But I think we'd all agree, probably, that if Countdown was a drink, It would be tea, I think. So tea is the theme of my game today. I'd like you to think of at least six films with tea in the title. It's a very narrow game, this one, but try it at home. And to take us into the break, there's a short poem by Ogden Nash, and this is dedicated to anybody who has ever tried in vain to get a child to eat. And it's called Lines to be Embroidered on a Bib, or The Child is Father to the Man, but Not for Quite a While. So, Thomas Edison never drank his medicine. So, Sir Thomas Malory never ate celery. So, Socrates and Plato ate dessert without finishing their potato. So, spinach was too spinachy for Leonardo da Vinci. Well, it's all immaterial, so eat your nice cereal. And if you want to name your own ration, first go get a reputation.
Very clever, Philip. Very clever. Slightly less clever, much less clever, is our tea time teaser. Here's the what you'll see on the screen. Am Pisces. And the clue, it'll help you get away from it all. It'll help you get away from it all.
Hi, I'm Pam and I'm from Bedford.
What is that?
It's a bubble.
The bubbles are melting.
Delicious Aero Bubbles melted to pure chocolate pleasure. Have you felt the bubbles melt?
Do you look after your health? You Magazine, the new weekly glossy that's all about you. Out now, only £1. Are you ready to be a mother? You Magazine, the new weekly glossy that's all about you. Out now, only £1.
Life can make your hair thin. New Pantene Pro-V Full and Thick Collection. Our unique Pro-Vitamin lightweight formula penetrates hair deep, leaving your hair looking noticeably fuller and thicker in just 7 days. New Pantene Pro-V Full and Thick. More to play with. Pantene is now recommended by the Institute of Trichologists, the UK's hair experts since 1902.
Channel 4 has a brand new show for Sunday nights. It's got a presenter.
You're an absolute disgrace.
It's got celebrity guests.
Absolutely baffling.
And television clips.
What's not to like?
TV Heaven, Telly Hell. Sunday at 9:30 on 4.
Do you get migraine?
No. Headaches. That's 9.
There we are. It'll help you get away from it all. Escapism.
Yeah. Karen, how about nice
that?
Word.
Now, what about Philip's little teaser?
More pure escapism. My particular tea time teaser.
Yeah.
Films with tea in the title. As you'd expect, there are quite a lot. Quite a lot of them have oriental themes. There's The Tea House of the August Moon with Marlon Brando in terrible makeup. The Bitter Tea of General Yen. Remember that with Barbara Stanwyck? And if The Bitter Tea of General Yen sounds scary or unpalatable, at least, what about Tea with Mussolini? Couldn't get much more scarier than that. Yosojiro Uju made The Flavour of Green Tea Over Rice. Baffling. And Doris Day, of course, entranced us with Tea for Two. Deborah Kerr was very understanding over the sputtered scones in Tea and Sympathy.
Yes.
There's the very peculiar surrealist film, The 5,000 Fingers of Dr. T. And I found out that the working title of Simon Pegg's wonderful zombie comedy was, in fact, Tea Time of the Dead. And as a penance for wasting your time with such trivia, our producer has made me come up with the following, The Darjeeling Buds of May. Don't know what that means.
You miss one.
Yeah?
E.T.
Very good.
Now the score, our champion, I'm calling him champ today because we have two Ians, our champion Ian Graham has got 26 points, but our challenger is 2 points ahead at the moment, Ian Alexander. He hasn't been behind very much since he's been here for the last few days. Now, Ian, it's your turn with the letters.
A consonant, please.
L.
And another.
R.
And another.
S.
And another.
C.
And a vowel, please.
O.
And another vowel.
E.
A consonant.
R.
Another consonant.
T.
And another vowel, please.
And I.
And your time begins. Okay, Ian.
Eight.
Champ?
Eight.
Go on, sir, you do yours.
Cloister.
Ian?
Costlier.
Cloister and Costlier.
Yeah, both anagrams each other, very good.
Very good eights.
Yeah.
There's another eight, which was a word I didn't know, which is quartiles, but I think it's another term for a cloister, really, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. It's an enclosed area. It's an Italian term. So in Italian buildings, you'll have a quartile.
Quartiles.
Yeah. Good countdown word, that one.
It is. Right. Quartiles. You see them in northern Italian cities quite often, don't you? Oh. Quartile. Eight points apiece, so 34 and 36 now. And now, Ian Graham, our champion, we'll have your letters, please.
Consonant, please, Carol.
Thank you. P.
And another one.
K.
And another one.
G.
And the vowel.
U.
And another one.
E.
And another one.
O.
And a consonant.
N.
And another consonant.
L.
And a final vowel.
And I.
Off again, gentlemen. Graham?
Seven.
Our other Ian?
Seven.
Go on, sir.
Eloping.
And?
Eloping.
Same. Seven apiece.
No, pitifully, we only had sixes until the very last second when we caught up with them about eloping as well.
Yeah.
But couldn't do better at all.
No. Okay. Eloping's the word. Very, very tight game we have here. 41 and 43. Our champion is behind by those 2 points at the moment. Now, Ian, your choice of letters, please.
Consonant, please.
Thank you. R.
And another.
L.
And another.
And F.
And a vowel.
E.
And another vowel.
A.
A consonant.
R.
A consonant.
T.
Vowel.
O.
And a consonant.
And a consonant, thank you. And D.
And we'll start the clock.
Seven.
Champ?
Seven.
Go on, champ.
Floated.
Yeah. Ian?
Oh, have a leotard.
Leotard. The most famous countdown word,
I reckon. The great favourite countdown word, yes.
Yeah. Yes. Now, that's been on countdown hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of times.
Yeah. More than either of us.
Yes.
Exactly. It hasn't got a football shirt to prove it. Philip, what did you get there?
Just the ubiquitous leotard. I started off with a fedora, but I thought I'd better get fully clothed and put a leotard on instead.
Great. 48 and 50, still very, very tight indeed. Now, our champion, it's your choice.
Consonant, please, Colonel.
W.
And another one.
T.
And another one.
S.
And a vowel.
E.
And another one.
O.
And another one.
E.
And a consonant.
N.
And another consonant.
X.
And another consonant.
And a consonant, Ian. T.
Thank you, Mr. Graham. come to our champion first this time.
Seven.
Ian?
Seven, but I'm not really sure.
You're not really sure. We'll have a go first.
Wettens.
Not sure about that. Champ?
Extents.
That's fine, I think.
Is that
yes,
okay?
Extents is fine, yeah, with a T rather than a D. No wettens, it's just a wet as the verb, I'm afraid. Bad luck, Ian. You probably knew that.
But you can have extents with the S.
You can have extents with an S, yes. Mm.
Extents, oh yes. Mm. Okay. Absolutely, yeah.
Do you know what? I thought it was... You said extents.
No.
So I was thinking, oh, there's only two E's.
It's when you leave the campsite, extents.
Do you like camping?
What sort of camping?
Oh, you know, proper camping. Not camping it up. I know you love that.
Well, I've learned. Many years ago, I did a bit of camping.
Yeah?
Yes.
Abroad?
Yes. Yeah. Little green tent, you know, which you put up yourself.
Yeah.
But, yeah.
We used to have to do it when I was small in North Wales, in Snowdonia. Never rains there. Puts you off for life.
I'm more inclined towards the five-star hotel. 7 points there for Ian Graham. Gives him a lead now, 55 and 50. Still very tight indeed. We're going to have some numbers. And Ian, it's your first tilt at the numbers with Carol.
I'll try two from the top and four little ones.
OK, two from the top, four small numbers. Two, three and four. Right. We have then eight and two, two and four. And from the top row, 175 and a target of 663.
663. Got this, I don't know, Ian.
I think I've got it, but I haven't written it down.
Haven't written it down. Champ?
No, I haven't got it. I've got 664.
664. Right, that's one away. Ian, see if you can do it.
Right, okie dokie.
Okie dokie, here we go.
Eight minus two is six.
Eight minus two is six.
I'll go back a bit. 100 minus 2 is 98.
Yeah, you have got it right. 100 minus the other two is 98.
Multiply them together.
588.
And add 75.
Absolutely right. Spot on, sir. 665.
That's very good. I think it's about the first time, Ian, champ, that you haven't got the numbers game in all, isn't it? I think you've nearly always got them, but you just missed out on that. First time you've been beaten on the numbers anyway, I think. But there we are. There we are. And our challenger now has a 5-point lead, so it's going this way and that way.
It's a good super game. We love it, the Ians, by the way, when it goes like this. You probably hate it, don't you?
No, it's a super game. I hope you're enjoying it at home. We'll have a tea time teaser so they can relax for a couple of minutes, and you'll see on your screen sun toads, and the clue, it shocks and surprises. It shocks and surprises.
Now give me a vowel.
E.
Everything is melting.
When the world is on the edge of disaster.
Maybe we can rapidly evolve into water creatures.
That's genius, Sid.
Call me Squid.
There's only one thing to do.
What?
Run.
Manny, Sid, Diego, and Ellie.
Somebody here likes Sid.
Ice Age 2, The Meltdown.
Coming up.
Try to touch the sun.
Touch of Sun, the new fragrance from Lacoste.
Academy Award winner Judi Dench had a brilliant best.
It's had naked girls.
Pardon? A deliciously charming comedy.
I rather like that, thank you.
Mrs. Henderson presents on DVD now.
Do you always like to look your best? You Magazine, the new weekly glossy that's all about you. Out now, only £1.
What the hell kind of nun are you? Look, if you try to come between me and my husband, I will take you down.
It's time for the pleasantries to end.
You do not want to start a war with me.
The gloves are about to come off on Wisteria Lane. Desperate Housewives, Wednesdays at 10 on 4.
I think you've got astigmatism.
I can't. There's no G.
Astounds. Astounds. It shocks and surprises. Astounds.
Nice one, Desmond.
Good one, wasn't it?
Nice one.
Yeah. I spent hours on these. We've got a very tight match here this afternoon. Our champion, the champ as I call him because we've got two Ians, the champ has got 55 and our challenger, Ian Alexander's got 60 at the moment. And now the champ, we'll have your letters, please, sir.
Consonant, please, Carol.
S.
And another.
N.
And another.
P.
And a vowel.
I.
And another.
E.
And a third.
I.
And a consonant.
M.
And another consonant.
B.
And a final vowel.
And E.
And the usual 30 seconds. Our challenger, Ian Alexander.
I'll try a seven.
And the other Ian?
I will too.
You both try sevens. Right, Ian.
Nimbies.
Nimbies. And champ, Nimbies.
Oh,
is that Nimbies, any good?
Acronym for not in my backyard. Yeah, it is there, but it's there with a capital N. Oh. And the plural is YS, not IES.
Ah, so.
Go figure. But I'm surprised by that.
Bad luck. So, what do we do, Philip?
We have to be stern, Des. We have to
say
no.
We have to be stern. We have to be strict.
A simple note. It's the kindest way. And we go instead with the six-letter word pie-men.
Pie-men.
Several of the people that Simple Simon met on his journey.
That sort of thing. Yeah, pie-men. So no point scored there. It remains 55 and 60. And now, Ian, when you've had your little sip of water. No, you're all right. Sip away. It's allowed. That's allowed on the show.
Is it really?
Oh, absolutely,
I shall sip away.
It's gin. It's gin.
I'm not that strict.
Off you. It's gin. It's a Saturday.
Well, if it's mine, it's gin. Off you go.
Okay, consonant, please.
Thank you. P.
And another, please.
V.
And another.
T.
And a vowel.
A.
And a vowel.
O.
And a vowel.
E.
And a consonant.
F.
A consonant.
R.
And a vowel, please.
And a vowel, thank you. And you.
And your time begins. Champion Ian Graham.
Only six.
Ian?
Only six.
Let's have yours, Ian.
Vapor. Vapor.
And the other Ian?
Powder.
Powder. Vapor and powder.
Yeah, powder pigeon. That's fine.
That was the pigeon. Yeah. Could have had favour as well, F-A-V-O-U-R, but we can't do better than six.
Nothing better than that.
No.
Quite a tricky selection, wasn't it?
It was.
Yeah.
Powder. Not nice.
Carol. That's what they do. Steady. I saw that Pete Burns did on Big Brother, didn't he?
Steady, Carol.
Permanent pouting.
Steady, Carol. There's a lot of sort of gentle people watching you now.
Really?
Yes. It's
really?
An afternoon show, Carol.
You make a great centurion. You could be our gladiator of the day, couldn't you?
Could I?
Yeah, centurion, yes, absolutely.
Oh, centurion, yes. Yeah, I'll think about that for 10 or 15 minutes. And we'll give you the score, 61 and 66 at the moment. And now we'll have our champ's letters.
Consonant, please, Carol.
Thank you, B.
And another.
C.
The third.
T.
A vowel.
A.
Another vowel.
E.
Another vowel.
A.
Consonant.
D.
Consonant.
T.
and a vowel.
And E.
We're starting the clock. The last letters game. Let's see how we did, Ian.
Six.
Six. Champ?
Six.
Go on, sir. Yes, you.
Battered.
Ian?
Debate.
Debate.
Yeah, both fine for six.
Battered and debate.
Yeah.
Absolutely six apiece.
You could have had abetted, as in aiding and abetting, for seven.
Yeah, double T.
Couldn't they?
They could have. They could have, yes.
But quite a tricky selection again, wasn't it?
Yeah. They haven't been nice this time.
Not too easy at all. 6 points apiece, still a very, very tight match, 67 and 72. We just have two rounds left, one of which is the numbers round, and that's for you, Ian.
I'll try the two from the top and four little ones again.
OK, two from the top. You like that, didn't you? You've been practising with two from the top.
Oh, no.
Are you sure? Because that was a very good numbers game we did before. And four small numbers, yeah?
Please.
OK, we have then six and six, two and nine, 75 again, and 25. And a target of 726.
726 it is. Right, and you picked them. That was your special selection. How did you go?
725.
725, one away. Champ?
726.
Right, sir, off you go. 726.
6 multiplied by 2
is 12.
Plus 9
is 21.
Plus 75 plus 25.
Oh, where are we going here? OK, plus 75 plus 25 is 121.
Multiply by the other six.
Multiply it by the other six. Oh, very good. Yes, 726. Very good.
Very handy indeed. Did you wonder where he was going?
I did, yes. I did a completely different way in, but very good. Very good.
Yeah. So you just missed out on that one. But it makes the score very interesting for
it
us,
does. If not for you.
For us, because the champion's gone back into the lead by just 4 points. You know what that means, don't you? And the people at home know what that means. We dim the lights, we create a little bit of atmosphere in the place. Heaven knows why, but we do. And you'll get your fingers ready on the buttons there, and we'll have today's crucial countdown conundrum. Yes.
Outlawing.
Let's have a look. Well done, sir. So we have a new Ian as our reigning champion, Ian Alexander, ladies and gentlemen. Enjoyed that, did you?
At the end. Title. Just after conundrum, I enjoyed it.
The other Ian, were you close to the conundrum?
No.
No, couldn't get it. Couldn't get it that time. But you've had a terrific run, haven't you? I mean, reasonable. Five wins is a terrific run. You get a teapot and everything. Yeah. So back to sunny Dumbarton, is it? And
well, it isn't sunny, but back to Dumbarton, yes.
Well, thank you very much for being with us. You've been a delight and you've done very well, we think. So thanks very much indeed. Give him a nice send-off. Nice tight game, Philip, wasn't it?
It was an extremely exciting game. I think they'll be cheering in the streets of Dumbarton when you get back. Yeah. We've had a nice time leafing through the dictionary during, you know, when we're trying to find a word of proper length. And I've just noted down a couple of fabulous little words that have leapt out. They're both in the letter M. One of them is an Australian term for a left-handed person, which is a molly duker. Have you come across that? As in put up your dukes, but in a kind of rather soft sort of a way, presumably. Yeah. And the other one, which is my absolute favourite, is a marabunta. Do you know what a marabunta is?
I do not, sir.
A marabunta is a social wasp. Now, presumably, that is a wasp that doesn't want to sting you, but wants to sit down and have a jolly nice chat.
Perhaps make a quiche. Thank you very much, Philip. We'll see you on Monday. And, Carol, thank you very much for my present.
Did you like it? It was
love
from
it.
All of us.
I'm going to go and put it on and run around the block going, I've lovely. Scored.
Can I take the photographs?
You can. No. But thank you very much all the same. Very nice of you and very kind of you. And thank you all for your wonderful support on the show. And we'll see you again on Monday afternoon at 3:30. Thank you so much.
Well done. You are our champion this week.
Oh, lovely.
Now what's the longest word you can see?
Life depends on the warmth of the sun being trapped by a layer of gases that surround the Earth. We now produce so much of these heat-trapping gases that the world is getting warmer, causing climates to change and threatening our way of life. As the world gets warmer, the extreme effects we have witnessed may become more frequent, making our planet a more hostile place to live. If we could see the gases, the causes of the problem would be obvious to everyone. And if you could see the effect we are having on our planet, you'd do something about it. The solutions exist, and it's not too late to make a difference. But we have to act now, today. Government, industry, and individuals acting together to tackle the problem. For more information and to get involved, visit climatechallenge.gov.uk. Tomorrow's climate is today's challenge.